My name is Derek Gordon. I'm an associate professor, just recently tenured in the Department of Genetics. Statistical genetics is also the field of study whereby we use statistics to localize genes that increase risk for disease. You can break it down into, I would say, two major areas. There are people who you call methodologic people. They develop new methods. And then you have those who are what's known as applied individuals. In other words, they want to apply the methodology to novel data. My primary interest is in developing new methods that localize genes for disease. I collaborate with researchers in scoliosis, in Tourette's syndrome, in other forms of mental health. Each of us, our chromosomes are made up of what's called 3 billion base pairs. Like, if you think of it, you have two telephone book full of letters, A, T, C, and G, in some combination. One you got from your mother, and one you got from your father. For the most part, as you can imagine, we're identical in that telephone book. We'd have to be, because we're all human, right? But there are places where we differ. And if someone inherits a particular base pair, they have a risk of getting a disease. Maybe it's a mutation or something like that. Typically when we do genetic analysis, statistical genetic analysis, there are two pieces of information we need to have. We need to have the phenotype, the condition, and as I mentioned, pieces of that phone book. Nowadays we're getting much closer to having every individual's phone book available to us. Up until, I would say, 2 or 3 years ago, we never had that kind of density of information. We would have maybe one every, say, 10 million letters we could get. Now, one of the technologies that's available is called next generation sequencing. We can get virtually every letter in the phone book. And so you can imagine that with that brings a whole host of statistical issues, right? So that's what I'm working on. That's one example of something that I'm working on, developing methods to analyze data that come from these phone books, if you will. When we look at individuals who have a particular disease, we don't know if they have it due to a gene at one location, or maybe they have it due to mutations in genes at multiple locations, or maybe there's a combination of genes and some environmental condition, or something along those lines. We don't know. I like to use the metaphor of the cake. I call it unbake the cake. What is it? Well, what goes into it, right? You have flour, you have sugar, eggs, you have maybe vanilla extract. When you get the final product, you don't know all the ingredients that went into it, right? And if you think about it, diseases are very similar to this. I know, at least in part, some of the pieces that went into this cake. I may not be able to find all of them, but I can find some of them. You know, can I find if there is a gene or a combination of genes? Or is it due to the fact that I live in an area where the pollution levels are extremely high? Right? These are all what we call the pieces of the mixture that we're trying to tease apart. I use what's known as mixture models in statistics, which is basically all the separate pieces that you put together to create the phenotype, the cake. But what you want to know is what are the underlying factors that are causing it. What we do is we simulate data where we know the truth. You see, when you're dealing with real data, you don't know what the true situation is. But if we simulate data, if we create data that looks identical to the real data, but for which we know the truth, what we can do is we can incorporate values that estimate the proportion of individuals or the probability that an individual has the disease due to a gene or has it due to something else. You know, the people who are the eggs versus the people who are the sugar, right, for example. It's fascinating work. I mean, it's really fascinating. So that's really, that's the core of my methodologic research. It's extraordinary how beautiful the natural system works, you know, and the things that we can do in this world with just our minds. It's really quite extraordinary. And I think mathematics is one of the most beautiful subjects I've ever encountered, and there's a sense of fulfillment one gets when one does this research. So.